Hey, what's up, YouTube? It's abluegolfball today from the Pokemon TCG Online video, and today I have for you guys a Flygon deck. It's a 140 HP Dragon-type Pokemon, all the way back from Boundaries Cross. So right now in the standard format, we still have Boundaries Cross going forward, so this is the oldest set in the standard format right now, and thank goodness Boundaries Cross is still viable. We have the ability Sand Slammer here. Anytime between turns, you can do 10 damage. Put 10 damage counters, or not 10 damage counters, one damage counter equaling 10 damage on each of your opponent's Pokemon, including the active Pokemon. The attack here, we're not going to be using it at all since we don't play any grass energy whatsoever. Flying Beatdown, so it's not too much of a concern. What we want to focus on is Sand Pulse, okay? So we can do 50 damage, and it does 10 damage to each of your opponent's bench Pokemon. Pretty handy, okay, alright. So how we're going to pull this off is what we're going to use is Shrine of Memories. Now you're thinking, why don't you just play Celebi EX? Well, I want to play Shrine of Memories because we've got a Shrine theme here, because Ninetale has this ability, Barrier Shrine. Each player can't play any stadium cards from his or own hand. So what we can do is play our stadium and counter our opponent's stadium perhaps and knock it out of the stadium spot. And then what we can do is play Ninetale and lock up the stadium. And then this way, we would have a Shrine of Memories to stay. So the problem with Celebi EX is our opponent can definitely just Lysander it out and knock it out and take two prizes. With Shrine of Memories, and we can lock it up with Ninetales, yes, granted, my opponent can still Lysander out the Ninetales and knock it out, but my opponent would only be taking one prize instead of two. And my opponent would still need to counter our stadium. And we are running two of them, so it would be pretty hard to counter. Maybe not, I don't know. But the Shrine of Memories, the effect of the stadium is that each player's evolved Pokemon can use any attack from its previous evolutions. That way, we can have Flygon on here with the ability Sand Slammer and still use Sand Pulse and do 10 damage to each of our opponent's bench Pokemon. And then over time, between phases, going into my opponent's turn and my opponent's turn coming back to my turn, we can do 10 more damage. Wow, that is pretty slick. That's 30 damage total in one turn phase by using Sand Pulse combined with Sand Slammer. And let alone you're doing 50 plus 10 more with Sand Slammer on the active Pokemon, that's 60. You slap a Muscle Band, that's 90. Okay? And then, of course, you're coming back and you're doing 10 more damage, so that's 100. So even if you have a Muscle Band, you're still doing 90. That's two-hit knockouts on most EX Pokemon. As for the other supporting Pokemon, we do have Hawlucha here with Flying Press, being able to hit for 60 on Pokemon EXs. And then we have the big bad Landorus here with Hammerhead. It's just a really quick attacker, very aggressive attacker. The problem with this is it is a Stage 2 deck, so it's going to be very hard to set up, and it takes a while. Landorus EX is just really quick, you know, big, basic EX. It does have a hefty retreat cost, but we'll deal with that in a little bit. As for the item cards and aspect of choice here, we got a Computer Search, discarding two cards and search for any card you want. We have Professor's Letter, just to get the energy into your hand. We have three switches. Now, this is the reason why we play Landorus. We can have the three switches here, being able to retreat, in a sense, the Landorus, right, without paying that retreat cost. It also works very well for situations where we get paralyzed or something like that, and we could just use the switch. And let's say, for example, we have Hawlucha on the bench, and we have our Flygon that's paralyzed. Well, we can just switch I'm losing my tongue here. The Flygon into the Hawlucha. Wow, that was just awful. Anyways, we got the VS Seeker here. Two of these just to get the support cards back into our hand from the discard pile. As for our support line, we got Colrus, one of these. Two Lysanders, one Lysander Trump card. Four Ends, one Professor Dirt Purchase Observations. Well, actually, I got two of these in my deck. We have the Professor Jupiniper here, just to discard a hand, draw seven cards. And then a Shrine of Memories, I already talked about that. Three Muscle Bands and one Silver Bangle. As for the energy line, we have four DCEs, six Fighting Energies, and two Fighting Energies. Strong Energies, I mean. So that's only for the Hawlucha and the Big Bad Landers. So without further ado, let's go ahead and see this deck in action on Pokemon TCG Online. Here we go. Flygon Shrine, the Flygon Shrine deck. Okay, looks like we're going against Kogler, and it's a Fairy, Psychic, and Lightning something rather deck. We're going to go for Heads, and yes, we do flip Heads. Thank goodness we get to go first. We start off with a Flygon. Can't complain right there. We even get a couple of Ultra Balls, which we can search for our Trap Niche and whatnot. I'm going to have to wait and see what my opponent starts with. With the Hawlucha, it's really good. We have the flexibility of free retreat. Definitely need that. That comes in handy. We see the Mew, so I'm thinking this is going to be, this might be some kind of Night March deck, I would assume. So let's go ahead, we'll get, definitely play this year. We didn't see my opponent play anything else, so I'm beginning to think that perhaps my opponent doesn't have anything in particular. So let's go ahead, we're going to get rid of this, and we'll even get rid of the other Ultra Ball. I think that's pretty good. We're going to get rid of the Lysander, there's nothing else to Lysander. What I really want to do is get the Trapness going. Since we can't attack on the first turn anyways, we're just going to go ahead and drop the energy over here. And then we're going to end the turn. So in the next turn, if we don't see my opponent do anything else, we're definitely going to be playing the fighting energy onto the Hawlucha and just hit the Mew for 60. We see a Roller Skates hitting Tails and Colgler here. Missing on that opportunity. We don't see my opponent play any other basics on his side of the field. We do have this Mew here, though, with the versatile ability. Not sure. Maybe we might get flying pressed ourselves. That would be pretty devastating. Okay. So the Mew can be in any kind of deck, really. You know, with the ability to be flexible, you can be stuck into just virtually any kind of deck. But most likely, it's a Night March deck. And there it is. It's a Night March deck. We see the Joltik hit the field. We also see a Professor Sycamore discarding Pumpkaboo and a Lampent. I think if my opponent doesn't attack us and we survive the turn, I should be able to put on 60 damage on the Mew. If only we played Fighting Stadium. it could be a one-hit knockout if we had the Strong Energy Muscle Band Fighting Stadium. That would have been 120 damage. But wow, look at that. If only my opponent has the energy drop and the stadium, what is that called again? Dimension Valley. We'd definitely get knocked out here, and no. So here we go. We're going to put some pressure on. I'm going to play the Strong Energy over here. My opponent didn't really do much else. I'm going to go ahead and go for the N. Give us a shot at evolving here. We even get another Hawlucha. So let's go for the Flying Press, hitting for 80. And the Joltik over there can definitely help the Mew right now. My opponent missed an energy drop, so that was kind of crucial, meaning that I probably should have not considered playing the N now that my opponent might have an energy and might have the stadium as well. So if my opponent has a DCE, we definitely get knocked out. My opponent could just copy the Joltik. But if not, then we could survive the turn. So we see here the Eevee hits the field. We also see an Ultra Ball getting rid of a Joltik and a Pumpkaboo. So right now we got four Lampins, two Pumpkaboos, and a Joltik. Oh, that's pretty heavy duty right there. That's 140 damage, knocking out even a Flygon if we had the Flygon. So I'm going to have to cross my fingers and maybe we can get a Lysander's trump card. So we see my opponent go for a Pumpkaboo with that there. We see the VS Seeker probably going for the Sycamore, discarding my opponent's hand, including the Pumpkaboo. And that, yep, as expected, there we go. So if the Hawlucha gets knocked out, I think I'll just respond with the Vibrava, I suppose, and just kind of knock out, you know, the Mew. That's an option there as well. But ideally, I'd like to get the Flygon going. Oh, there's the DCE, and I'm gonna promote the Hawlucha. That way, we just get the free sheet. Otherwise, the Mew would be. Hopefully we can knock out the Mew. There we go. That's 160 damage on the poor little Hawlucha. Let's go ahead. We're going to promote this. So here is the question. Do we want to promote... Well, you know, we got a Landers here, which we can knock out this Joltik. I see here we got two Pumpkaboos and a Joltik. So my opponent would need another Joltik, if anything. So that's always an option as well. I can definitely go with that. We even have a Lysander that we can play. So a couple options here. I think what I want to do is Lysander out the Joltik. I think that's a very viable option here and just kind of chip away at everything. We can definitely do that, or we can retreat, take a risk, and see if we can get an energy drop and then just kind of knock out the Joltik by hitting for 30 and then 30 to the Joltik. So this is a tough call, very tough call. You know what, I'm gonna take the chance here. Let's go for it. Let's go for the N. Oh my goodness, we get it. And wow, we get everything we need, everything we need right here. So I'm gonna retreat into this guy, and we'll knock this out, and we'll even knock all the jokes out. Oh wow, such a lucky end. That is ridiculously lucky. And we even get a Flygon and a Vulpix. That is insanely lucky. I have never gotten so lucky in my life. I'm just kidding. I've probably gotten luckier draws before, but... Okay, let's see here. We see the Mew. My opponent definitely need another DCE and another Joltik to do something. Otherwise, my opponent would probably just pass the turn. We see the Flareon over there. That's pretty scary. Flareon is going to be pretty pumped up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 Pokemon in the discard pile plus 20 damage. That's 120 damage plus a Muscle Band. That would be doing 140 damage. I think my opponent does play Muscle Bands. I'm not too sure. But that would knock out our Flygon, and that's pretty vicious. We see the Mew EX here. Nothing yet. Nothing happening yet. I think with this kind of scenario, I'm going to go with the Muscle Band onto the Flygon. And definitely going to go, you know, I don't know. Maybe we can... I want to switch into the Hulucha to give us the flexibility to kind of go back to this anything we want. So the plan here is going to be playing the Muscle Band, switch into the Hulucha, and then play Juniper. And that way we can hopefully get the Shrine, right? The what is it called? The Memory Shrine or Shrine of Memories. Evolve into the Ninetales. That is the hope and the dream here. And if we can do that, that would be a fabulous day. Otherwise, my hope here is that my opponent does not get a DCE or anything else. Ooh, we see a Slurpuff. That's interesting. Probably helping for a draw support. And the Pumpkaboo goes in the discard pile as well. So my opponent gets the Dimension Valley going and gets the Mystery Energy. So no Joltik, not being able to do the Night March. My opponent hits us for 150 to copy the Vengeance here. But that's okay. We do have a Silver Bangle, so we can probably play that on the Hulucha. Or we can play that on the Flygon. I'm going to play that on the Hulucha, and I'm going to play the Muscle Band on the Flygon. I'm going to switch into the Hulucha, and then I'm going to Juniper my hand, and look at that. This is fantastic. So a couple things here. What we really need to do is... let's see, we can play the strong energy. So right now, I think I'm just going to end up sacrificing the Hulucha. Yeah, so we need a DCE. That's what we really need. But I'm going to hang on to the Muscle Band, I guess. Or not. I'm going to hang on to the VS Seeker. Let's go ahead. We're going to get Shrine of Memories out here. And we'll counter the stadium and then lock it up with Ninetales. And here we go. Let's go ahead and do the flying press for 110 damage. One short. But when we get Flygon going, Flygon should be able to knock out the Mew on the bench if my opponent doesn't heal it. So that's going to be the plan. Oh, wow. My opponent even gets another energy. And we will see my opponent go for... not sure. We will promote... I think we'll promote the Flygon. I think that's probably the best choice here. I think promoting the Flygon would be a pretty good choice. We could always use Landorus to clean things up. But, I mean, if anything, we can probably play the Landorus. My opponent would take another prize. Yeah, let's go with the Landorus. I think that's a pretty safe bet. I'm going to go for the Juniper over here. And I really need a DCE. And we do get a DCE. That's fantastic. Let's see here. We can definitely put a lot of pressure, and we will knock out the Mew. But okay, so here's what we're gonna do. Let's see. Let's just go ahead. We'll Hammerhead. Okay. So I'm gonna play this here, and that gives us an option to play DC either on the Vibrava or the Flygon if need be. So we're gonna sacrifice the Landorus. I'm gonna knock out the Mew, and I'm gonna put 30 damage onto the Flareon. Let's take two more prizes there. We even get a Flygon, so my opponent can definitely end us. That would be pretty devastating, but either way, my opponent will still need a DCE, and I don't know. This is pretty dim right now. We see a DCE. That's going to knock out the Landorus. Do we see a Lysander? If we see a Lysander, that's going to be very devastating. If we see a Lysander onto the Flygon, I think our hopes of winning is going to be done for. But no, never mind. And here we go. Flygon is going to save the day. And, man, Flygon came Didn't really get to do too much. Flygon, you didn't do much at all, man. I'll just do the samples, and, you know, there we go. Darn it! You stinking Flygon, you didn't do nothing, man. Okay, I think we need to play one more match here, because Flygon was a lazy guy, and he didn't do anything but at the end. So let's go ahead and play one more match here on Pokemon TCG Online. Okay, looks like we're going against Joey Joestar, and that's going to be, it looks like some kind of metal, psychic, and a lightning deck of some sort. My opponent gets to go first. Yeah, not sure what we're going to be going up against here. We start off pretty strong. We start off with a Hawlucha. I'm going to go with this. Hopefully my opponent doesn't end us. I'm going to hang on to the Landorus here. Oh boy, we see a Hawlucha, or we see a Zubat, we see an N. A bunch of different things going on here. Verbing City Gen, that's going to be pretty troublesome. And it ends up to being our turn, so look at that. Let's go ahead, we'll play these two Trap Ninjas over here. We'll even play that there. Let's retreat into the Landorus. My opponent has Fighting Resistance, but, I mean, this is really our only viable choice right now. There's not much else we can do. Let's see, my opponent has Lightning and Metal. That's going to be interesting. I think there's some other things in his deck as well, so I'm not too sure. My opponent does have the advantage, and we do see some pretty cool sleeves. We see the what is this? This is the championship sleeves. I'm not too sure if that's the 2012 or 2013 or 2014 championships. But if you're watching the video, you can comment below and say, hey, those are the 2014 championships or whatever. My opponent plays a Professor Sycamore, discarding the Jirachi. That's probably the metal in this deck. We see the Hypnotoxic Laser flipping for Tails. What we can do next is probably just play the energy onto the Trap Ninja and then play the Vibrava onto the Trap Ninja as well. And now it's our turn. My opponent has yet to do too much. And I think that's going to be game. And boy, that is not too good. So we take the victory there. I'm going to go ahead and play another match. Oh man, that's no good. So it's my second match. I'm going to go ahead and play one more match for you guys. Because my rule of thumb is I try to get at least three good matches, and if I can't get a third one for you guys, then you know, that's too bad. So all right, so one more match here for you guys. Okay, so yeah, I'm not too sure what happened there. I think that Zubat just, you know, that Zubat deck just couldn't get anything else on the bench, and then luckily I drew into a Muscle Band, you know, because with that resistance was finally able to finish off that Zubat, right? After Landorus. Okay, so we see a Byakuya 87. It is a Psychic, Leaf, and Colorless deck. I'm going to go and see if we can go first. But no, my opponent flips for heads and gets to go first. We start off with a Trapnich, and we do get the Ninetales that we don't exactly need right now. Definitely will play the Vulpix, and we'll take a peek at our deck. Hopefully, you know, I'm going to discard the Ninetales because, you know, we don't have our Shrine just yet. Oh boy, my opponent gets the Leafeon right away. That's pretty scary. But, you know, if we don't have any energies on our side of the field, then we don't have too much that we should worry about. But, oh wow, we even see a gold Rocky Helmet. We see a Colorless Machine. Wow, my opponent can do a Leaf Blade. Oh boy, that's not good. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead. Let's just attach this here. I think we're going to go and discard the Colress. Sure, why the heck not? I don't think we need the Silver Bangle because it doesn't look like this deck will have EXs, I don't think. But you know what? I kind of want to go aggressive. Let's go with the Landorus. You never know when off this Juniper I can get a switch. And no, we don't get the switch, but we do get this here. So we can try to go for a Seathering Smash, and this would actually bypass the Rocky Helmet since we actually don't attack. So let's give that a shot. Let's go with the Seathering Smash, and no, we get Tails, darn it! Our Trap Niche is going to get knocked out if my opponent has the energy drop, and that is going to be brutal. We don't even get to evolve, man. That's just harsh, you know? Ooh, we see a Genesect over there. Oh, wow, we even see the energy drop. Oh, man, That's no good. Okay, so we are weak against water. I don't think my opponent plays any water. I'm not too sure. And, oh, wow, even flips heads. Dang it, there goes our muscle band, and I shouldn't... Oh, darn, I got rid of that silver bangle. Totally regret that now. So let's go ahead, we're going to play this here, and we even get a computer search. So I'm going to go, and I'm just going to discard these. I'm going to end up needing to get another juniper anyway, and discard a bunch of stuff. So here we go, we need to draw into some new things. We even get a muscle band, that works very well. I'm going to go for the hammerhead. This would be a two-hit knockout onto Leafeon. So the Leafeon can still respond with 80 damage, and that would put us at 100, but we'll just knock it out, and I don't think the Genesect has too much to respond with. We do see a plasma energy, definitely being able to draw out a Hawlucha. Oh boy, that could knock out our Hawlucha. If my opponent goes for a Leaf Blade and flips heads, that would be a knockout on our Hawlucha. So that would actually preserve our Landers a little bit more. But man, my opponent is just not missing a beat, getting two Culverse Machines going here. I think, right? Was that two Culverse Machines? I'm not too sure. Or maybe that was just one. I was pretty sure my opponent played two. Actually, no. He only played one. And... and so, yeah, okay, so thank goodness the Hawlucha didn't get knocked out, so I'm going to retreat into here. Let's go ahead. I'm going to just play the DCE onto the Trap Niche here. And I'd like to play an N, that way we can evolve, but at the same time, I don't want to give my opponent any more cards, so we're just going to hang on to that. Let's go ahead. We're going to knock out this Leafeon, put some more pressure on the Genesect over here. And dang it, we really need to get the Flygon going, man. This deck is a Flygon deck, you know? oh shucks. Okay, so Genesect over here gets an energy drop. We can always hit the Genesect again. Ooh, my opponent goes for a teammates. Either way, my opponent shouldn't be able to knock us out because my opponent needs another grass energy. What my opponent would need to do is, I don't know, maybe teammates for an ether or something. I'm not sure. Yeah, that's probably the only option there. Otherwise, my opponent wouldn't be able to knock us out anyways. Using a Megalocannon plus the Muscle Band, that's only 120. Would be 20 damage short of knocking out our Landorus. But with the teammates, my opponent can draw into... who knows what my opponent can get. Maybe even a Juniper for the next turn. Or maybe another Pokemon for the bench. I'm not sure. So here we go. We don't get to see what my opponent draws. That's pretty sneaky. We see the Venusaur EX. That's pretty scary over there. We even see a Muscle Band onto the Venusaur EX. And that's it. Passes the turn. Let's see here. We got a couple things we can do. I'm going to go ahead and play this energy over here. And I'm going to go for... I guess I'm going to go for the N, I suppose. I mean, my opponent doesn't play anything else. I don't know. I'm not too sure. Okay, so let's just go. We're just Hammerhead. You know what? We'll just play it slow. If my opponent has the energy, you know, so what? We'll still survive the turn, and then we'll just knock out the Genesect, and then kind of hit the Venusaur. Oh boy. Well, we should still survive the turn, and we will do 70, and that would knock out the Genesect DX. Anyways, oh no, we see an Enhance Hammer. I didn't see that coming, and oh boy, we are down to 10 HP. My opponent actually opts to hit the Trap Niche when my opponent could definitely have hit the Hawlucha. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring out the Venusaur. I don't see my opponent being able to switch or anything like that. So let's go ahead. I'm going to go for the Hammerhead and just kind of chip away at the Genesect and also at the Venusaur. My opponent would need a switch, and that would actually finish off both the Landorus and the Hawlucha if my opponent chooses to do so. But never mind. We see a DCE. This is going to be a 4 retreat cost. There it is. My opponent is down to no cards. I'm going to go ahead and draw the last two energies here. And you know what? I can probably just discard... I don't want to play an I don't know. Maybe I'm going to keep at least one energy in handy. But let's go ahead. We're going to get rid of the Lysander. I think that's a pretty good choice. I'm going to hang on to the switch in case we need that. And bring out the Vibrava over here. Let's go ahead. We'll charge up the Hawlucha in case we still need to do that. Let's see. Yeah, let's just go with the Hammerhead. And that puts the Genesect in knockout range. I really wish we had the Lysander. Oh boy, my opponent plays a Skyla. Could definitely go for the switch. And That would jeopardize my plan, that's for sure. But we do have the Vibrava here. We can evolve into the Flygon. That would knock out the Genesect going into his turn, or from his turn to my turn. And then, I guess we'll just chip away at whatever else. We can actually knock out the Venusaur. Never mind. We see a Professor's Letter. My opponent can knock us out with a Poison Powder, but I'm glad that it wasn't a switch. That way, we don't see the Genesect coming out to knock out the Hawlucha and the Landers taking three prizes. So here we go. My opponent will take two prizes here, but we will be taking three prizes ourselves. There we go. That my opponent knocks out our Landorus, and here comes Flygon. Come on, folks. Hype it up. We got to hype this up, guys. Flygon, this is the cornerstone of this deck. This is the leader of this deck. This is what this deck is built around. We even have the Shrine of Memories over here. So my opponent's down to three cards. I'd rather have a shot at getting five cards than getting four with the Professor Birch's observation. And let's go ahead. We'll go with the N, and we even get the Landorus over here with a strong energy. So let's go for the Sand Pulse. Look at this. Knocks out the Genesect. Oh my goodness. Taking four prizes right here. Oh my goodness. That is wicked. Oh wow. That is great. Okay, so my opponent is left with a Genesect. We have yet to see my opponent play any more bench Pokemon. We just need to get the Ninetales into play, and then we can lock up that stadium. We don't have to really care about that anymore. Oh, we see a... Oh, boy. So we see a Viaseeker. I think what I want to do is probably Viaseeker for the Mr. Mime, because I think that's the weakest thing right now. And it's protecting the bench, right? So we want to do that. We even see a G booster. That's pretty scary. So a couple things here. Do we want to Lysander out the Mr. Mime? I think so. I think that's going to win us the game, and we're going to do that. Lysander out the Mr. Mime. Sand Pulse knocking out the Mr. Mime. 0-0, and there it is. And victory it is, finally. Flygon finish things off. And Landers doing the dirty work. So, oh boy, this is a fun deck. Being able to put up a lot of damage onto the bench Pokemon. Let me know in the comments below what do you guys think of this deck. If you guys have any other deck ideas, feel free to shoot them my way, and I'll see too if I can build them. If you guys haven't subscribed already, please do give this video a thumbs up. Hopefully, you guys have a good day. I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.